Hi, it's Rick with LearnDigitalAdvertising.com, and today we're going to go over the new lead form ad extension in Google Ads. Today is October 22nd, and this mostly released a couple days ago. It's still in beta, so we are only seeing this in English language. We're also only seeing it in select accounts, and they seem to be higher spending accounts. And basically what these extensions do, we got a little screen capture here for you. This allows the end user to basically do a form submit straight from Google. So if you're trying to get users to download a white paper or maybe get a, you know, contact you, get a free consultation request, something like that, you know, this could be a good extension to run. Let's just talk quickly about how it works. First of all, what are you paying for? You're paying for clicks to open the form. So you're not paying for the form submit itself. This works a lot like call extensions where you don't pay for the call, you pay for the click for the call. So there's going to be that inevitable drop off. So we're interested to see, you know, from a cost structure, you know, how many people based on the offer and the client and everything like that would click to open the form versus those who actually fill it out. And that'll probably improve over time as I guess end users get more used to this. So that's how the ad unit works. At this time, you can basically capture the user's name, email address, phone number, and postal code. And when the lead is submitted, and this is the part our tutorial today is going to help you solve this problem, it basically just stores in Google. And you can export that as a CSV later. There's also webhooks, meaning that you can pass that lead information to other services, your CRM. If you use something like IntegraMAT or Zapier, you can then capture that webhook and, you know, send an email or add it to a spreadsheet, that sort of thing. So let's jump right in. We'll set one up. We're also going to today use Zapier, and we're just going to pass our leads to a spreadsheet just to kind of show you what you can do with that webhook. No programming skills required here. So marketers, if you're not using Zapier already, it's a great product to use. So let us jump right in. First thing, we're already zoomed in on this particular account to ads and extensions. And what we're going to go ahead and do is click to add a new extension, and you'll see here the lead form extension. So if you don't see this yet, it's just not open for your account yet, should be soon. So what we're going to do first is choose a call to action. So you can see the ad preview here on the right side, and our call to action in this case is going to be contact us. And that text is going to maybe be a free consultation. And for our headline, we may see also do free consultation, business name. I'll just use business name for now. And then we get a 200 character description here. So, you know, contact us today to sign up for your free consultation. This is not a lesson in writing ads, people, so please bear with me. What information do you want to ask for? So we're going to, in this case, maybe just capture name, email, and phone number. And again, you can see on the preview side, our form is beginning to fill out. Google requires a privacy policy URL, so I will just do. And what you can also do with these for design element is add a background image. We're not going to get into designing it right now, but creatives can use your imagination to make these stand out a little bit. Now the submission message is what happens after the form is submitted. So thanks, we'll contact you soon. And then you have the option to have a call to action. So that could be none, visit the website, or download. So you're going to get pinged for another click here if you want them to visit your website. I don't think it's a bad idea. But that's up to you and the application, you know, that you have specific to your business. So we're almost done now. The extension's almost complete. What we want to do next is this lead delivery option. So realistically, you have to use webhooks or come into Google every day and download your CSV, because there isn't an option to get these emailed anywhere at this time, and there may never be. What we recommend for this, and if you're not used to this service already, there are services like Zapier and IntegraMAT, and they don't pay us to talk about them. They're just here and great tools. And what these tools basically do is allow you to do things like hook into webhooks and then send your lead somewhere. So let's just set that up quickly, and I think that'll illustrate a little bit better what we're going to do. So from Zapier, we're actually going to create our webhook. So I'm going to go ahead and make a new Zap. And within Zapier, we have something called Webhooks by Zapier. And our event is going to be to catch a hook. And again, we're just configuring this so that when the lead comes into Google, we can send it to a Google sheet. And now Zapier gives us a webhook URL, and this is what we can actually plug in on the AdWords side right here. And we're going to continue. And now it's going to ask us to find data, so we're going to test and review. And what I'm going to do quickly here from Google's side, they let you send test data, so I'll just hit that button. And on Zapier's side, we can see that Google sent us a sample. And that sample basically just contains some dummy data for full name, user email, phone number, that sort of thing. So these are all the fields that we asked for in our form, basically. So all we're really confirming now is that Google's able to communicate with Zapier and send those values. So now that we have set up our webhook, what we need to do is tell Zapier where we want to send our data. So what I'm going to do in this case, for simplicity, is just send it to a Google Sheet. So I'll grab Google Sheets, and I'm going to have it create a new spreadsheet row. And you should know that before I'm doing this, I had set up sort of a test Google Sheet here, and it just got a single column for lead information. And this is where we're going to end up passing the information. So we're going to ask it for each new lead to create a spreadsheet row so that our team can check for new leads once a day. And we're just going to connect to our Google Sheets account here. And if you use Zapier, this will all be very familiar. If you don't, there's a wizard as you go through all this that helps you set this up and connect to your account and everything. It's all really easy to do. You don't need to be very technical to do it. And then the spreadsheet that we're going to connect to, and then the worksheet that we're going to connect to. And now what it basically asks us is, it identifies that we have one column called lead info, and what do we want to drop into that field? And in this case, we're just going to drop the payload of all the data that we just grabbed, meaning it'll, again, pass the end user's name, email, and phone number. We're going to hit continue. So at this point, what we've done is connected Zapier to Google Ads, so that each time a lead comes in from our new lead ads, Zapier can grab it and send it to a Google Sheet. I'm going to send a test here real quick to make sure this does what it's supposed to do. I'll go over to my Google Sheet, and now you can see my test data in there. So the way this app is going to work, each time a new lead is going to come in, it'll just drop it in the next cell down. A couple things to think about here. Zapier does have tools to parse this a little bit better if you want to have the name in a certain column and the email in a certain column and that sort of thing. For the sake of this video, we just want to keep it pretty simple. We're just going to drop it all in there. So now that this Zapier is set up, we're basically just going to say that we're done and we're going to turn it on. Okay, so that is about it. What we, again, covered today, the new lead form extension is about as easy as most other extensions to set up. The reason this one's kind of a little bit more complicated, and maybe there'll be some solutions to this that are a little bit better in the future with Google Ads, is that the delivery of the lead is maybe not what you're used to. Typically, you're getting that form submit through your website or something like that, or now this is basically going to force you to either set up the webhook or just export your leads daily. So we'll have some more videos in the future. We're running some tests on this. It's a brand new type of unit. Just kind of curious to see how this cost per lead and the quality per lead is compared to that what you would get through your website or other sources. So have fun with it. Comment below. You can always learn more at learndigitaladvertising.com or like us, subscribe to us on Facebook. Thanks again.